over this bridge, and then you walk to there. So there, you see there the light.
Yeah.
Behind it, there's a cafe.
Yeah.
And that's a really strange, beautiful cafe.
Oh, so cool.
It's called Nelson Mandela.
Wow, amazing.
And they are called like that because if you have a fight with somebody, then you go there and you have to make it good. That's the business idea of them. Okay, still closed. Sorry.
Nelson Mandela. I may have to go there as
It's called the Mandela House.
Mandela House.
And so even a lot of companies are coming there when they fight.
That's amazing.
Yeah. And they got it from the city for €1 because of the business idea.
Yeah.
So it was on a very central point and they overlooked the whole city.
To go into the butcher's restaurant, right? You know the restaurant?
Yeah.
Is it nice?
Yes, it is. You see this building? Mm-hmm. That's where the butcher's is.
Is it?
The butcher's social club.
So it's half time and now we're running quickly just to go get a bit of pickup probably. Yeah, I want to get a lighter because I've been here for how many days and I still haven't got myself a lighter. I brought one over with me and I lost it, so you know, now I'm going to have to find one, find a new one myself. But yeah, I don't know where we're going. Harry, if you're watching this, I hope you flag down the waiter or waitress that brings a blue cheese burger. Please. Anyway.
Yeah, my bad.
Obviously, Manu won, what was the score? And who are they facing?
Chelsea.
Chelsea, 2-1 to Chelsea.
Which is Zoom in the
Laughing Buddha.
Yeah, yeah, Zoom in his face.
You taking the L, bro. You taking the L.
You just gotta hold it sometimes. That's the face of defeat. Right there. Right there.
Look down.
This shit makes you sleepy. This shit makes you sleepy. I think it's a lot of it is a bit of a load of shit though. You're paying more for the fucking creative name than you are for what it is.
That's pretty much the same in Bristol though. Like, when you're picking up or something like that.
Oh,
when you're trying to get above, like, someone would say it's like super lemon or something like that, but really it's just like, just a kush or something like that, you know what I mean? It's selling, it's tactic.
Well, I didn't need to know, you know, I've been smoking meat since I was 13, and I never needed to know anything about sativa or...
I don't know if it's weed.
Yeah, you just buy some fucking weed. You're like, I want to buy some weed, and now I'm going to get high.
Yeah.
And now it's like, ah, oh, but do you want the sativa? Or do you? It's like fucking Subway. It's like, all right, just give me a fucking sandwich, man. Like, yeah, but what do you want on your sandwich? It's like, I want what's in the picture. Just give me what's in the fucking picture, please.
Definitely, I reckon, like, 50% of all the customers that we get in the bar are from the UK. I'd say it's a boomerang, but I don't want it to go back to the person I stole it off.
And also, people coming into the country boosts our economy, you know, because they all buy houses and bring all their money over, which is fucking awesome.
So what, you work here in Amsterdam?
Yeah, bro. Yeah. I work up at a bar down the road.
The bar, okay.
It's called Slanchies.
How long have you been working there?
Only like a month.
A month?
Yeah. Okay,
cool. Wait, what's it called, sorry?
Slanchies.
Slanchies.
Yeah, it's really weird. It's an Irish name, bro. Yeah. But it's like a... fucking cool bar, like if you guys ever feel like a breakfast in the morning, it's like a good Irish breakfast, like it'll pull you up, like super greasy. If you want sausages and eggs and stuff.
Well, I'll keep that wide though.
Well, the
the normal one that we have is a jumbo breakfast.
Oh yeah.
And that's like 10 euros.
It's good for it's good if you, you know, like if you want to seize the day, you're on holiday, yeah, and you're having a few beers at night, you still want to, you know, do shit during the day. We get a lot of hungover people, right? They always leave feeling a little bit. Yeah, bro, it's just up the road, like 20 meters up the road. I'd never worked in a bar before, eh? See some fucking crazy shit, bro, especially in the red light.
Like what?
Like, people that aren't on mushrooms, like, they are fucking day trippers, you know? Like, you're not gonna come out of it.
So why are you working over here? What made you come here?
I'd never been to Europe before, bro. You know, I had big plans. I sold all of my property and shit. By my parents' property off there.
Okay.
And they had like a bit of a spot for a workshop. I was going to start a business up and everything. You know, whenever you do a real estate deal, you always have clauses.
Yeah.
You know, like pending finance. Meaning if you don't get the loan, you don't have to go through with it.
Yeah.
Well, theirs was pending their business sale, but it wasn't on paper. Because it was family, you know?
Yeah.
So they couldn't sell their business. And I had already sold my house, and I was fucked, bro, you know? So I just decided, fuck it, bro, I got no commitments.
Yeah.
You know, still in my 20s, come over to Amsterdam. I got a nice Kiwi mate, he met a nice Dutch girl.
Okay.
So he's here for like 3 months before me,
yeah,
which
yeah,
is good, bro, because if you're gonna go to a country, like, you need to know someone that's already been through all of the steps, you know? Like,
yeah, yeah.
This is how you get a visa, this is how you get a house. But I've only got, like, probably 6 months left, so.
Okay, then what's happening after then?
They tell me to fuck off, basically, bro. Yeah, yeah. Oh, well, I'm not part of the European Union like you guys.
Mm.
So, if I want to stay
yeah.
and I want to get a job,
yeah.
it has to be a real good job, you know?
Yeah.
Like, something that the employer can prove that all of the people living in the country can't do it, you know? If I got a job in a bar, I could definitely not use that as a, like, a place to stay, because there's not anyone can work in a bar.
That's true.
So yeah, basically, bro, it's 6 months, it's game over. Unless they find me a nice Dutch girl, you know?
Are you gonna go next?
Bro,
how long
to be perfectly
left?
Honest, I'm gonna catch a flight to Denmark, and then my bro's gonna pick me up, and I'm gonna jog straight back.
Nice.
I've got shit to do here, so.
Nice.
I think I'll be okay.
My brother Harry, happy birthday.
Happy birthday.
Well, you know.
It's right.